Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Now in this week's video, I will be talking about things I wish I knew before I started doing programming and coding and all that stuff. So I'm guessing you guys are familiar with like my background of how I attended uni for like 2 years at UN studying computer science. Then I left, now I'm in Moringa doing like a coding programming bootcamp. So I just finished the prep course, which is like the first 4 weeks course. And then now I'm on to the core, which is a bit longer, it's like 15 weeks I guess, and that's where you like specialize in a specific field, I would say. Now I do have a couple of things I learned, things I wish I knew back then was patience. You need to have a lot of patience, guys. Sometimes things don't work out as you would like them to, like your page is not running, so many bugs you can't see, or like there's an error that you can't seem to fix, or you just can't seem to grasp a concept, and it's fine, I promise you. It's fine. In my first week, I used to stress about that a lot. I'd be thinking, oh my god, all these other people, they're advancing way quicker than I am. They're understanding these things. Their code is running perfectly fine. But you won't have the same struggles as like the next person. You know what I mean? Everyone's struggles are different. You might be struggling like in this first week, and next week's content, you're probably good. You know what I mean? So patience is very important. You just need to take time with yourself to understand, because it will come. You will know what you want to know by the end of it. So patience. What else? I would say working with others, very important. I wish I knew this when I was in uni. I never used to work with anyone. Like even when it came to exams, I would read alone, probably ask one person here and there, you know what I mean, just a few questions. But then when it came to like my studies, it was all me. And when I joined this new place, it was all about teamwork, which I fell into it easily because it's just so natural. I know a lot of people think when you're doing programming, you're just like stuck in your basement or in a dark room where you haven't seen sunlight, had any human contact for like a month, and you're just on your computer. But that's not how it works. I feel like you need to work with people to learn from each other, to grow each other. That's something else. Working together, working with people. There's also all like many online platforms that help you work with other people, you know, collaborate with other developers and whatnot. So that is something I wish I knew when I was in uni. Something else I wish I knew when I was in uni was knowing the basics. Like when I left uni, I was like, the level I had reached in uni, I was meant to know a lot of things by then, which I didn't, which I low-key blame the school system. I'm sorry, but I low-key blame the school system. It wasn't as sufficient as I would like it to be. But you just need to know the Kawa basics so the things become clearer, you know what I mean? You don't need to dwell on the basics that much because it does get complex as it goes. So familiarizing myself with the basics was so important, would have been so important. Obviously, I'm not talking about like how to use a computer and whatnot. That's completely different. I feel like everyone knows that type of stuff, but I'm talking about the actual like basics of coding, you know what I mean? So that's another tip I'd give you guys. Just familiarize yourselves with coding, the basics and all that stuff. I don't know why I'm dancing. Something else I wish I knew, which is probably like a tip to you guys, is working outside of the schoolwork. And just once you learn something, don't just stay there. Try to grow from it during your free time, or like during the weekends when you have nothing to do, or like just any free time you have, try building on the knowledge you have. Like probably just start a new project on your own, which you're implementing everything you've learned, and then just keep building on it as you go. Increase that project. This kind of ties in into the practice because you are practicing, but the more projects you do, the more you're building your own portfolio, more like your CV will be stacked because you have all these other additional stuff you're creating. So that's another tip. So the final tip I would like to give you guys is being ready to learn. As you guys know, tech is always improving. There's always new innovations. You know, it's a field that moves forward very quickly. So you're probably going to learn a new thing every single day. So you need to be ready to learn that and to balance it out. You know, you don't need to be feeling like, oh my god, learning basically never stops, but it's not a bad thing. So you need to be ready to be learning new things as you go, if that makes sense. Yeah, I hope that made sense. So I hope you guys enjoyed this very quick short video, but these are a few things I wish I knew before I started coding, and these are a few tips I would like to share with you guys. If you enjoyed this video or want to see more of these like school related tech-related videos, not tech-related, but like my school journey rather, let me know in the comment section below, or give this video a thumbs up, and I will definitely be doing more. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. That would mean so much to me, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.